Hey everyone, Chris Lawler here. It's January 26th and welcome back to Hollywood Highlight right here on Back to the Podcast. Today, we've got a lineup that's absolutely sizzling with hot trailers and the latest Hollywood news. We're checking out Jake Gyllenhaal's Roadhouse, diving into the eerie world of Immaculate, and there's some buzz about Jamie Foxx as Spawn. I have so much to talk about, so let's not waste time and get to it. First up, let's dive into Immaculate. This psychological horror film releasing on March 22nd this year has Sydney Sweeney leading us into a haunting tale set in an Italian convent. The story starts with a seemingly serene backdrop, but don't let that fool you. It is packed with eerie scenes and those jump scares that have you clutching your seat. At the heart of it all, Cecilia, played by Sweeney, is entwined in an immaculate birth, shrouded in mystery. Is this a divine miracle or something much more sinister? The film promises to unravel this mystery in a chilling narrative. This one caught me by surprise. I am always skeptical about horror movies, but this one definitely raised my eyebrows. I'm intrigued to see how they tackle this subject. I am looking forward to Immaculate in March. Have you seen this trailer? Did this give you goosebumps? Let me know in the comments. All right. Up next, I wanted to discuss the trailer Sleeping Dogs. This one's got Russell Crowe and Karen Gillan leading the charge, and it's shaping up to be a wild ride. This is being helmed by Adam Cooper and is scheduled for release on March 21st of this year, right around the same time as Immaculate. Crowe plays a former detective grappling with Alzheimer's, and he's pulled back into an unsolved murder case, with Gillan's character adding layers of mystery. The film is a mix of crime, drama, and some intense psychological twists. Adam Cooper will be making his directorial debut with this film. He had worked primarily as a screenwriter before, notably co-writing the screenplay for Tower High starring Ben Stiller and Eddie Murphy. This movie feels like a real departure from that. Filmed in the scenic backdrop of Victoria, Australia, Sleeping Dogs is stirring up some serious buzz. Stay tuned for its release and let me know in the comments, are you ready for this thrilling journey with Crowe and Gillan? Let's really get into this new Roadhouse trailer next. It just dropped yesterday. It's stirring up some serious excitement because it's more than just a remake. It's a reimagining of a classic. So Jake Gyllenhaal steps into the role of Elwood Dalton, a former UFC fighter who becomes a Roadhouse bouncer. The trailer sets the tone with hard-hitting action and a gritty atmosphere. Directed by Doug Liman, a master of action films such as The Bourne Identity, Mr. and Mrs. Smith, and Edge of Tomorrow, Roadhouse promises a fresh take on the 1989 film, blending MMA fighting with intense drama. The film also stars Conor McGregor, adding authenticity to its fight scenes. Set in the Florida Keys, this new version seems to crank up the intensity, promising a high-octane experience. Scheduled for release on Prime Video on March 21st of this year, it's going to be a treat for fans of action-packed cinema. What are your thoughts on Gyllenhaal tackling this iconic role? Did you see how ripped he was in that trailer? I mean, Gyllenhaal's always been in good shape, but he seems to really be enjoying these very physical roles, and he's kind of getting up there in age. And then Conor McGregor looked very intense and seemed to bring some real gravitas to the scenes that he was in the trailer. So I hope you guys enjoy that one. It looks like it's going to be fun when it does release. I'm eagerly awaiting that here in just a few short weeks. Moving on in Hollywood Highlight, let's talk about the big screen return of Christopher Nolan's TENET. For those who missed it or just want to relive the experience, TENET is coming back to theaters on February 23rd, and it's not just any re-release. We're talking 70mm IMAX, IMAX Digital, and 70mm film screens. The full Nolan experience, if you will. Plus, there's going to be a sweet bonus. Exclusive footage from Dune Part 2 will also be revealed. It's a week-long event, so mark your calendars. Now, the big question, will they tweak the sound design? Can I actually understand what they're going to say in the movie this time? I know that was a lot of people's complaint about the original, was it was just impossible to hear the dialogue. I had just moved into my house when that had come out, and I had just set up my sound system, and I really thought that it was the sound system and not the movie. So I had spent forever just trying to tweak it just so we could hear anything. And then it turns out it was just the movie and not the sound system. I guess we'll find out either way. It's a chance to dive back into Nolan's mind-bending world. What do you think? Are you going back for round two with TENET? Let's chat about it in the comments. All right, folks, let's dive into the Borderlands movie. We've got some exciting updates here. The film, initially directed by Eli Roth, has a new twist. Tim Miller, known for Deadpool, stepped in to oversee reshoots while Roth was busy with his horror project Thanksgiving. So what does this mean for Borderlands? Well, we're still in great hands, obviously. Miller's got a knack for blending action with some great humor, which is perfect for the Borderlands universe. Now let's talk about the cast. We've got Cate Blanchett as Lilith, Kevin Hart as Roland, Jamie Lee Curtis as Tannis, and Jack Black voicing Claptrap. But the one I'm really excited about is Cheyenne Jackson as Jacobs. You remember him from 30 Rock, right? He's transformed into this towering figure, and I cannot wait to see him bring Jacobs to life. Ariana Greenblatt is Tiny Tina, and Gina Gershon is playing Mad Moxie. It's shaping up to be a stellar lineup. If you're new to Borderlands, expect a wild ride with its unique blend of over-the-top action and quirky, sometimes immature humor. Sometimes being the loose word in that sentence. The games are known for their crazy characters, intense gunfights, and that distinct Borderlands charm. The movie's set to capture all that madness. So are you as pumped as I am to see how this all comes together on the big screen? All right, everybody, get ready for some thrilling news here. 28 years later is officially in the works, and it's bringing back the original Dream Team, Danny Boyle and Alex Garland. This isn't just a sequel, it's the start of a brand new trilogy, apparently. And guess who might be returning? Cillian Murphy, fresh off his success in Oppenheimer. Murphy's potential involvement has us all buzzing. The original film redefined the zombie genre, and with Boyle's direction and Garland's writing, this sequel could be epic. The anticipation is real. What do you think? Are you as pumped as I am for this reunion? I love that franchise, so to hear that it's coming back and in a strong way is very exciting. Now, really quick, we're gonna wrap up today's Hollywood highlight because we got to talk about Spawn. Jamie Foxx is set to lead in the reboot with Todd McFarlane's full backing. Todd McFarlane, the mind behind Spawn, is confident in Foxx's portrayal, despite some development delays right now. McFarlane's words, full of faith in Foxx, emphasize his dedication to the project. Quote, until Jamie says he can't, he's still my guy, end quote. And his remarks about Foxx's strong-willed nature and determination reflect his unwavering support. This reboot with Foxx at the helm promises a fresh and exciting take on the iconic character. This news has me very excited. Jamie Foxx is an incredible talent, and I could really see him taking on a Spawn franchise. I would be happy if I could just see one, but it would be awesome to see him portray this role for a little while. Spawn is an amazing comic book character, one of the few that I actually really enjoyed when I was younger, and I would love to see another movie, even though I still really enjoy the 1997 version as well. Do you remember the original with Michael J. White? What do you think of this news? And there you have it for today's Hollywood highlight. What's your take on Immaculate's chilling storyline? Are you excited to see Russell Crowe in a different light in Sleeping Dogs? And how about Roadhouse with Jake Gyllenhaal? Think it'll live up to the original? I'm eager to hear your thoughts on Borderlands as well. Are you as thrilled as I am about Cheyenne Jackson joining the cast? And finally, 28 years later, are you ready for more of that intense zombie action? Drop your thoughts in the comments and let's get a lively discussion going. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to Back to the Podcast for more Hollywood buzz. Thanks for watching and keep those movie conversations flowing. We'll see you next time.